After these two excellent welcome speeches, I just want to repeat once again that this is a great privilege for all of us Georgians to have such distinguished scholars, researchers, people who made such a great contribution, not only in your countries but in Georgia as well, to understand what's going on in Georgia after the breakup of the Soviet Union. And this is a great privilege to have here Stanford fellows, and I want to greet them with special respect. And there's one more reason why I feel some special connection with these fellows. It's just one letter, T, which makes difference me and you, because I am Stanford fellow. I graduated from Stanford School of Public Policy of Duke University. So it's great privilege for all of us who had the chance to spend years in U.S. universities and to learn more and to use that knowledge for the benefit of our country. And I am welcoming Georgian fellows who are here, and I know that it's their contribution, first of all, that we are gathering today here. And it's very symbolic that that decision was made last year in Kiev, in Ukraine. And when we are talking now about the modern state building, we cannot avoid this issue, the tragic events which are happening in Ukraine. And by the way, those events are happening with the flag and the modern state, New Russia, or Eastern Ukrainian new state, and so on and so on. And we see how cynical the real politics sometimes can get when the doctrines of democracy, liberal democracy, are used for such things, and people are dying, innocent people are dying there. And of course, our thoughts are there with the people who are fighting for free choice of their country and their homeland. And I believe this kind of events in Tbilisi, in Kiev, in Bishkek, in Moscow at some point, time will come, is very important in order to unite our world around the values which could save this world. Otherwise, we see how many challenges are emerging almost daily in different parts of the world. Therefore, it is very important to discuss for us, Georgians, what's going on in our country, where we are. And it's on one hand a great privilege that we have this conference called Building a Modern State in 21st Century Georgia. I would be rather happier to have a different title there, Functional Modern States in 21st Century Georgia, and then share the experience of functional modern state. But we are not there yet. But we want to come there, and that's choice of Georgian people. And the achievements, President, Prime Minister, we are mentioning here, are the achievements of Georgian people, first of all. And the very, very firm decision, very, very firm desire to be free nation, to be part of the democratic world, to be part of the humanity, which is trying to make this universe living place for every single human, without consideration of its ethnicity, religion, nationality, and so on, is our dream as well. Our dream has become true partly when just about 2 months ago we had this privilege to sign the association agreement with the European Union. And when the question was asked, why you Georgians want to sign this document so when the European Union has so many problems and some European Union countries are questioning whether the EU is functioning well and so on, our answer was that this agreement for us means much more than just the agreement. Because with that, we are finalizing our goal to feel ourselves as part of democratic world. And we want to live with the democratic world, and we are ready to suffer with the democratic world. We are ready to be engaged in lengthy debates how to make Europe better. And that's what makes us so much interested and motivated. Why? Because that's the civilization we belong. We don't know, Dr. Fukuyama, is that end of history, start of history, middle of history. We want to part of that history. And that's why, despite the fact that current Georgian state lacks some of very essential features of modern statehood, we are still proud of our country. You know that more than 20% of our territory is not controlled by the national government. And some other countries or people claim their sovereignty over that territory. How we could talk about modern state when that state does not have clear boundaries de facto? Of course, that's a huge problem. Mr. Prime Minister, I was talking about the first experience in Georgian history when the power was changed with peaceful elections. How we are talking about modern history when we have just one precedent of such things? Mr. President was talking about desire of Georgian people to be a democracy, but we have records of civil war about 20 years ago. Our last president is under prosecution at the moment. So these facts are not something which could be kind of characteristics or features of modern states. But these facts are underlining that we have job which should be completed. And we realize that. And this is the good news. And this government and this society and these people representing different parts of Georgian society, NGOs, scholars and so on, we all understand that we are in the middle of this process. And therefore such conference is so timely and so important. We are ready to share our experience and we are ready to learn from other countries' experiences and we are ready to part of this very important process. Thank you very much.